Dear students, today we are going to see about the lesson Discovering Tut, the Saga Continues, written by A.R. Williams. About the author, A.R. Williams, former senior writer for National Geographic magazine and online news. She was specialized in archaeology. She writes features about places varying from Egypt to as far as Alaska. She writes about any new discoveries that take place. Introduction about the lesson, Discovering Tut, the Saga Continues, gives an insight into the mystery of surrounding the life and death of King Tut. He was the last teenage ruler of powerful Paro dynasty. He had ruled Egypt for centuries. That means the Paro dynasty had ruled Egypt for centuries. King Tut was the last of his family. And his funeral brought an end to this powerful dynasty. Let us see the summary of this lesson, Discovering Tut, the Saga Continues. In this lesson, there are two things are discussed. The one is about King Tut's mummy, how it was found, and it had been taken to for a CT scan. And the second one, family and the history of King Tut. King Tut mummy was one of the first mummies to be taken for CT scan. As the mummy of King Tut was glided for performing a CT scan, angry winds still and dark clouds covered the stars. The scan was being done to underneath the mysteries that had surrounded his death. King Tut's mummy was in a bad state, according to Zahi Hawass, the Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities. King Tut's tomb, first discovered in 1922 by Howard Carter, a British archaeologist. King Tut was buried with a funerary trusses. Funerary trusses include precious collars, inlaid necklace and bracelets, rings, amulets and ceremonial apparel, sandals and seats for his fingers and toes. Because Egyptians believed in the idea of resurrection, it means a rebirth. Basically, Egyptians, they have belief in rebirth. And next is Howard Carter's investigation. Carter investigated the three nested coffins, because he only found King Tut's tomb in 1922. In the first shroud adorned with a garland of willow and olive leaves, wild clary, lotus petals and cornflowers were found. And Carter faced difficulty in extracting the mummy of King Tut. Howard Carter faced difficulty because the ritual resins had hardened, resulting in cementing of Tut to the bottom of the solid gold coffin. So there is no other way to separate the mummy from the ornaments than to chisel it. Chisel it away means that is to separate. It is head had to be removed and the major joints had to be detached. So Howard Carter separated head and major joints of the mummy of King Tut. Only ground for Carter to defend himself for chiseling. Carter discovered King Tut's mummy in 1922. Some 40 years after Carter's discovery in 1968, the fact was revealed in the discovery of an anatomy professor who had x-rayed the mummy. In 1968, an anatomy professor had x-rayed the mummy of King Tut, and he found that the breastbone and the front ribs of the mummy were missing. And next one is about King Tut's family. Amenhotep III, Tut's father or grandfather, ruled for almost 4 decades, 40 years. He ruled Egypt for 40 years during the 18th dynasty. It was known as Golden Age. After Amenhotep III, Amenhotep IV came to the throne. He was known as Akhenaten. He made some unpleasant and drastic changes. He promoted the worship of Aten, the sun disk, and changed his name Akhenaten. He moved religious capital to the new city of Akhenaten. He destroyed the images of Amun, a major god. After his demise, a ruler named Smenkhkar, regent for a brief time. Finally, after Tutankhamun came to throne, King Tut restored the old order destroyed by his procedures. So King Tut restored everything which is destroyed by Amenhotep IV, and he ruled for 9 years. King Tut is widely known today, died as a teenage pharaoh, and he was an ancient Egyptian king, and was buried laden with the gold. He was the last king of the family who ruled Egypt for centuries. His unexpected demise was a big event, and the reasons for his death still unclear. There are two questions are unanswered. The first question is, how did he die? And the second one is, how old was he at the time of his death? Because his death is a mystery, because no one knows. And this is about the family of King Tut and the history of King Tut's family. And then in the year of 2005, King Tut's mummy became one of the first mummies to undergo CT scan. It was done by Sahi Gavas. It provided precise data for an accurate photonic reconstruction of King Tut. Due to sand in the cooler fan of the CT machine, they had to use two plastic fans to complete the scanning process. While scanning the mummy of King Tut, the cooler was repaired, so that's why they used two plastic fans to complete the process. Tut's body was examined over a computer screen with the help of CT scan, and it showed a grey head, neck, vertebrae, a hand, several images of ribcage, and transection of a skull. After collecting the data for a scan, the pharaoh was sent back to the place where he was resting. It was a relief for Sahi Hawass, as nothing had done seriously wrong with the mummy. When they left the mummy in the place, in the resting place, the wind had stopped and the surrounding came to a deadly silence. In the sky, just above the entrance to Tut's tomb, stood Orion, the constellation, also called by the Egyptians as the soul of Osiris, the god of afterlife. The god of afterlife is watching over the boy king. This is what about the summary of this lesson. Thank you, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you.